Hi, this is Amber Brown, the new presenter for Liverpool Live TV, and I'm here outside the Playhouse, and we're about to interview the cast for the Norman Conquests. Hi, this is Amber Brown, and I'm here with Philip Cumbus, who's playing Norman in the upcoming The Norman Conquests. How's the rehearsal process going for you at the moment?
It is going brilliantly well. Yeah. We're nearing the end of rehearsals, so we're starting to complete piecing these three plays together. We've got three plays, three different sets here in rehearsal room, and here we are in the living room where the play that called Living Together takes place. And we've gone through each play and we've broken up the sort of chronology of the weekend where these plays happen, and now we're sort of piecing it all back together. So we're doing some brilliant work, and it's been very, very fun. Yeah. And we can't wait to sort of take it from here and move it into the theatre.
Yeah, because it's going to be coming onto stage on the 25th of May. So yes. 2 weeks' time. Is it ready to be on the stage yet, do you think?
Not quite, but then I don't think it probably should yet. Yeah. We still have these 2 weeks. So the 2 weeks, you know, three plays in rehearsing over sort of 7-8 weeks. So it's been incredibly busy, which is amazing to have as an actor. You sort of work very, very quickly. You have to discover the detail really fast, and you have to sort of make choices. But we're really starting to hear it come together. The yeah. rhythms of the writing are so brilliant and so rich that we're starting to get there, I think. So by the time we come to the 25th, it'll be bursting out of here, I think. And we're desperate for an audience to hear it and yeah. see it and enjoy it.
So it's a trilogy of plays. Do you find that has been a bit more demanding for you as an actor compared to just doing a normal straight play?
Yeah, it is. It's both more demanding and helpful in a weird way, because you've got, you know, if we were just doing this one play in this one room, you'd have its own set of demands and things that you need to get right. But because we have these other plays in the background, it means that actually you're learning about this play from what happens in the other two plays as well. So we'll do scenes in the dining room or out in the garden that actually inform what happens in this play. So in a way, it's it makes it easier, as yeah. well as being a challenge of having to remember, right, so which play am I in, which door do I go through, what happens if I take a prop from this room and bring it into the dining room? It all sort of implodes in on itself. So it's got a brilliant set of challenges, but okay. so far it's been delightful.
Okay. And do you have a favourite out of the three at all? Or?
It keeps changing, I think. They are really brilliantly different. You know, they all fit together and they all make sense of this incredibly chaotic and fun weekend. But actually, they have very distinct sort of tones and flavours. So as we go further into them, there's sort of bits of certain plays start to come to life in a way that is really exciting. So there's no favourite so far.
But like them all.
Exactly. And actually, the days when we do all three together will be extraordinary, because you'll be, you know, that journey of those characters, we will literally be piecing that together. Every single aspect of that weekend will be coming through on those trilogy days. So that will be amazing, as well as a bit scary.
Yeah. And how have you related to your character? I see you've got a beard. Is that out of your own choice, or is it?
It certainly isn't. No, this is 100% Norman. I love Norman. He is extraordinary in many, many ways. I find him sort of slightly terrifying in some ways. He's basically the bits, I think, maybe this says a lot about me, he's basically the, in many ways, he represents the things that we all probably really desperately want to be like, but actually struggle to be like a lot of the time. He's very brilliantly wild and chaotic and randy and funny and incredibly hairy and mad. And so all these things are really fun to play with as an yeah. actor. It's a great, great, great challenge. But yeah, I don't want to identify with him too much, because okay. he's also a bit naughty.
Is the beard going to go after the play, do you think?
It will go in stages. I'll probably just take bits out randomly, bit by bit by bit, until I've got nothing left. Yeah, okay. It's always a bit of a shock when you shave off a beard. Yeah. This mad, you end up looking a bit strange afterwards. But yeah, I'll probably shave it off afterwards. Yeah.
At least you look the part.
Yes, that's the first step.
All right. And have you been able to go around Liverpool much? Have you had much free time to...
No, I suppose it's the brutal answer. With a trilogy, it means we're rehearsing an awful lot. But, you know, we are based here, and we have been for the last few weeks. And so far, I've loved it. I've never worked here for a long period of time. I did a play at The Everyman for about a week a few years ago and loved it, but didn't have much chance to get to know it. Whereas now you feel like you're gradually starting to get to know the city. Yeah. And I look forward to exploring it a bit more once we've opened and we have our days free. But certainly the feel on the streets and the people have been amazing.
Okay. Do you have any future plans for when you finish here?
Other than shaving the beard, I don't know. It's wonderful, you know, in a way, what Norman does in his life is he's incredibly immediate. His world rotates around whatever's happening to him right there in the moment, and that is what makes him very exciting. And in the same way, you know, as an actor, you sort of don't know what's coming your way until it appears. So after this, I'll just see what happens. And
a bit ambiguous there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, great. Thank you very much.
You're very
Thanks.
Welcome.
You are pouring hot water on your puffer rice.